What's going on, everybody? My name is Jonathan Smith. Continuing our Eddie O'Grebo, let's get into it right now. First class cricket here at the Adelaide Oval. Let's get stuck in, and I think I probably want a good batting performance today as per usual, but we checked last time and a lot of our objectives were actually to do with our bowling. They were bowl maiden overs, bowl dot balls, take wickets. So for us, obviously bowling's going to be important. It's a hard dry pitch, which we should just bat first. It doesn't make sense to be bowling it because it's going to be harder and harder to bat on. I guess as the match progresses, there's going to be more cracks and stuff. Creates more variable bounce, creates more unevenness. I don't know, I could be talking shit out here, but hopefully the game does things like that. I feel like it does pretty well. Let's go. Yep. Cracking shot to get off the mark. That's probably the best first ball shot I've hit. Bang. It didn't even seem like uneven bounce. It seemed very predictable. Seems like it could be a really nice day to bat. And off the back foot again, another boundary. Jeez, it just races away. The outfield's quick. Everything's quick. Now, before we get annoyed, everybody, in the comments section by saying, why are you batting like a 2020 game in a first class game? I've faced three balls. I've hit two boundaries. Whoop-de-doo. All right. Some people say play patiently, but honestly, if I can hit the ball, I'm not being risky when I'm doing it. Aren't you being just a little bit too precious there? Oh dear. That was a nice ball. I was just playing a little bit too defensive, I think, here, and outside edge and out. So you're happy? Only scored 8 runs from 10 balls. I'm disappointed. So we thought it was going to be nice to bat on. We've ended up being knocked over for about 120, and we've got South Australia 4 for 95 as I come into the attack. That's David. Why is David Warner playing for South Australia? I don't know. Do any of you know? Because I don't think there's trades or anything in this career. So I wonder what's going to be the most successful way of going about things. Is it banging the ball into the pitch? Short stuff? So they lost 3 wickets for 1 in the previous over. Yes. And an outside edge. Could be a run out. Not to be. Oh dear. All of a sudden the game just changed. Was it a hat trick, you reckon? I think it was. Oh no, it wasn't, because it was a run out. Gee, that's stiff. So you had, who got out? Warner out by Madden. Carey got bowled first ball. Then Winter got run out. First ball. That's stiff. Wait. But it puts the Vicks back in the game. Wait. End of the over, just the 1 from the over. And I think it's from that outside edge. And enough for the lead now for South Australia. Oh, gee, that's a tight leave. Oh, he's chopped it on. Goodbye, Adam Zampa. I'll be happy with that wicket. It's the toe of the bat. And his middle stump out of the net, out of the ground. Another wicket for Victoria. South Australia 8 for 131. And it's not a bad position for us to be in. Only trailing by 8 runs. I haven't bowled super effectively. I've taken the 1 wicket for 20 runs, so I haven't been as economical as I normally am. Gee, that's an interesting decision to almost run there. But I have sort of, I don't know, bowled an odd length. An even line. I haven't really showed too much of a plan. 37 overs, 8 for 137. I mean, you can see with this over, just a bit of a lack of consistency. So back out to the middle after we bowled South Australia out. They made a lot more than I thought they would have in the end. McInerney putting on 85 to see that total up to 201 after what seemed like a pretty, you know, low score. So they were 8 for 131. The last 2 wickets put on 70 runs between the 2 wickets. So massive improvement from them and give South Australia a 78-run lead. And it's still reasonably good to bat on, but I need to just make the most of it. So my first class average is only 34, which is probably the lowest I think it's ever been across any of these video games ever. You know, going back to Don Bradman 14, always been sort of a, you know, 40 plus. Yep. This is the way I should just play every innings. With just good intent and a positive mindset. If I'm always trying to look to survive, I never seem to play that well. Ooh, no run.
Yes.
Yeah, we tuck it again away. Sort of back foot driver away for two. Gets us a couple more runs. Now, it's probably been both a strength and one of my biggest weaknesses. A lot of my dismissals come from trying to drive off the back foot, and that extra bounce on Aussie pitchers come from sort of, you know, that's sort of the area they target is, you know, get you fending away at that ball, and it ends up getting me outside. What is this bowling plan? It's so wide. It's not a one dayer, so wide Yorkers, I'm a bit strange as to why they're happening. But yeah, it's a bit different, isn't it? Anyway, this one beats the fielder past mid wicket. Should pick up three. And we get there quite easily in the end. It's been a good partnership to start, given how this hectic this pitch has been in terms of wickets being lost. And of course, commentator's curse, as soon as I say it's been a good partnership, we lose the opening wicket, 1 for 31.
Yep.
Oh, that's nicely played. Very aggressive and down, never really in the air or risky at all. Four runs.
Yep.
Oh, that is driven superbly past the bowler. I was a little worried at the start because I've had that many return catch dismissals of late. But I'm pretty happy with this one. Was it in the air? It was for a minute, but it's enough to go to the boundary for four. After the bowling of Nick Winter.
Yep.
It's a pretty easy dismissal to tuck away for one. End of the eighth over, 1 for 44. Look, I haven't batted aggressively. I know people might say that, but 29 from 18. I mean, I'm just hitting good shots. That's all it is.
What? Yes.
Yes, there is two. Gee, this is actually racing away. It's going to be four in the end. Like, you can't tell me that's aggressive. It's placing it onto the offside and it just goes past the fielder and then it just races and rolls away. It's four. And to be fair, I've had a bit of a horror run with the bat of late anyway. I don't think I might go check my man Hens after this, but I don't think I've made, I think I've made maybe a 50, but I don't think I've made 100 for quite some time. So I really want to bat really positively today and get myself back in the triple digit column. Just playing patiently, waiting for the delivery I'm happy to hit. And then I'm hitting it. Nine overs. I think there was a pretty expensive over that one. We were one down. I don't know if we're two down yet. No, 1 for 52. Yeah. Adam Zampa into the attack. I didn't actually realise there was a leg slip fielder there because if I did, probably wouldn't have hit that ball in the area I just did.
Yes.
Now I probably would have hit it here. Just got away with the one.
Yeah.
And again. But this time it's in a gap. Didn't think there was much gap to hit there. But again, just the... I'm just working it away. I'm not trying to smash it. But we're doing a very nice job. 44 from 27. Definitely has been one of the better innings in a single, so I'll retain the strike at the end of the over, 1 for 61. And now the lead is just 17, and we've only lost that one wicket. I'm in at one end, Pekowski at the other end. Maybe not in, but he's working his way into his innings. Hopefully he gets settled pretty soon. Short ball, not taking it on this time. Top ball, 12 overs gone. That's a much more dangerous angle, I reckon, for Zampa. Over the wicket. I reckon he's just changed around the wicket. No, he hasn't. They've taken out sort of the silly point. They had a lot of men around the ball. He's literally, keeper's throwing the ball at me every time. Doing the old Bairstow to Smith. The ball's too wide. It's, no, it's not dangerous there. I can just keep leaving it. Stop throwing the ball into me! Oh, good fielding. Keeps it to a maiden over. Oh, this could be in the gap. This could be at least two. No, we'll just keep the single. No need to risk anything right now. That's a 50 partnership as well. Up between these two. It's really good stuff. 48 now from 45. There's been some pretty good line and length bowling. This time just a little over pitched. Allows me to hit it to the offside. Come back for three. Actually, we could probably come back for four. You guys want to just run that one? Yes, we do. Half century up. 52 from 46.
Yep.
Oh, that's nice. Inventive, but nice. More of a swat than anything. Just the two. Worrell back on, so spin has come off. I thought Zampa actually bowled pretty well. I thought he was probably the most threatening of the bowlers. I don't think the pace in the wicket is all that there for these guys to keep going. There was a little bit of movement off the pitch there. Whoa, great shot. That's a bit of aggression and positivity for the boundary. And again, driven through that cover region. Just the length, still probably a little too full. Easily driven away. Oh, and again, this time, that's probably the best of the three shots. Just a push more than anything. Three boundaries in a row. I guess the one thing we've seen about this wicket is that you can lose wickets in clumps. So especially with the South Australian innings, they're at a similar sort of point. They're probably about 2 for 80-odd, and then in the space of 3 or 4 overs, lost about 5 or 6 wickets. That's too full. And you can't bowl there if there's a gap there. 100-run partnership up between these two. Just been playing cover drives for days. So I work my way towards the 80s. Oh, that's a good shot as well. Played behind square on the offside. It's not going to go to the boundary. Return, and we will come back for three more runs. This lead starting to grow for the Victorians. Now 56. We sort of accelerated in the past couple of overs, and now Adam Zampa back onto the attack. See, he was probably the best bowler, and especially bowling Zampa over the wicket, he's the most dangerous. Gonna have to defend very well here.
Yep.
Reverse sweep. Played nicely. And I'm just looking very, very comfortable at the crease right now. There is nothing that seems to be troubling me. That's probably a little bit of a moles on myself to say that. But I do look very comfortable at the crease. And another over. 1 for 136. The angle of his bowling is clearly a no ball. Like, what is going on here? He can't bowl that wide. Oh, there's a good single here. Deflects off the bat pad field up for one. The field is again sort of set for a short ball. So if he does pitch it up outside off, I'm smashing it.
Yep.
Oh, I've hit it very high. It's going to pass that fielder, I think. And it's going to be four. Wasn't exactly where I wanted to hit it. But it'll do. Into the gap for a single. 1 for 160. Lead now above 80. Andy Owen 92 not out. 16 fours. Tampa just a fraction straight there. Allows Owen to punch it through mid-wicket for four. Take him to 96. Especially with that short leg fielder not really paying too much attention. I feel like this field is set up for me to absolutely kill it. I was almost going to take it on. And whip through mid-wicket. There's a big ton. Very well fought. Over 98 deliveries. 18 boundaries. Oh, it's a big chunk of the runs in boundary form, but I played it really well at a time where it was required for the Vicks, and I am literally gone the very next ball. Was this a wrong? And it was. Yeah, just, all right, I wasn't even finished my celebration speech before I got bowled. Like, I played so well, I'm a little disappointed I got out on 100, because I thought I was going to make a really big score and put our team in the best possible position. I feel like my 100 probably still did a lot of that work, a lot of that groundwork there. In a game where not a lot of runs were being scored. Pekowski run out. But look at this score, 400 plus. Is this pitch flattening out and maybe a possibility for South Australia to chase it down? Where are we now? Where it might be on day three. So middle of day three. 159 more for South Australia to win. David Warner at the crease with Jake Weatherall. Both players settled and in. I feel like this field, I'm probably not going to get a wicket even with an outside edge. Wickets tumbling. This is going to be close. I think we've got it. We have Victoria winning by 31 runs. Alejandro Madden, the player of the match. What did he even do? He took 3 wickets. And what else did he do? And he took 2. So he took 5 wickets for the match. But in a match where runs were difficult to come by, I'd like to think he hit 17 runs in the first innings, I suppose. I made 100. That was pretty handy. I don't know. There was probably no real standout player in this match anyway. But good to get another win. Good to get 100. Even though it wasn't a big 100. Just a small 100. It's still 100 nonetheless. Pretty happy with that. So, as I said, look at our objectives. So many of them are bowling related. All of them are bowling related. Ball 400 dot balls, 35 maidens, and take 30 wickets. So hopefully we'll get those relatively soon, and we can get some more batting objectives because they're always good to have. We've got 7 skill points and a batting point after that innings. I don't know which thing I should put my batting point into, if I go into a specific shot type or if I just go bang, improve my defense. I think that's what I'll do to start off. Then I'll go to the bowling because I've still got 5 more skill points and I'll improve this stuff. So I'll at least, and we've got another bowling point, so maybe we'll go with the speed. I'll just increase it slightly. So I'll leave me 1 more bowling point to put in later. Teams from the County Cup are on the verge of offering you a contract, a couple of more strong performances, and I'm certain you're going to receive an offer from Tony over there, or Timothy, or Jimothy, or Stan. So this is how it is. Obviously very close to English County Cup selection. And getting attention for a lot of other things. We're obviously even getting noticed for the Australian side in both the test and the one day is coming up. Nothing so far for 2020s, as we haven't really played any 2020s, I believe, at state level. But I wanted to have a look at, what was it, my stats. I wanted to have a look at my man Hatton for the last little period. I guess in Shield cricket we haven't been too bad, but we played a lot of List A cricket, and you can see the last, like, 4 or 5 innings, there's been sort of some mediocre scores in their batting average of 66. I know it's like good, but it's, I don't know. I felt like we've been struggling of late. But anyway, that is it for today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoy it. And we will continue with more of this stuff at the MCG with a Victoria versus Tasmania game in the next episode. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you all later. Bye.